Ladies and gentlemen, Royal Rumble Weekend 2021. But before we get started with this, I have a little something new that came in the mail today. Yeah, got a Brody Jackson hat now. First of all, yeah, just ignore this thing on my chin. I don't know, it happens sometimes. But, yeah, so there's now a hat with my name on it. That's cool. This is like my first piece of merch. And I'm, like, super excited about it. The way we did it was we just ordered it online. We sent in a picture we wanted on there, and they printed it. Super easy. And it came in within, like, a week, which was awesome. So, that's really cool. If you guys would like this hat or one of similar design, let me know in the comments if you want it. Let's get up to 50 subs. We'll set that as a goal. If you can get us up to 50 subs, I'm going to be doing two different things. The first thing I'm going to be doing, once we hit 50 subs, is I'll be releasing a form free for anybody to use, where they can pre-order one of these hats, and we can get them made up and sent out to you. That would be really cool. And the second thing I'm going to do, at 50 subs, is I'm going to open my Discord server to the public. Right now, it's only myself and a couple specific people, but it's really quiet, and I want some people in it, and I made it for all the fans. And I officially want to also instate the term for the fan base. You know, Mini Lad calls his fans the lads. You know, back in the day with Equals 3, Ray William Johnson called his fans that he would address them as the Forum. So I decided that the official name of the fans of Brody Jackson, the official fan base, the group, the collective group of people that watch my videos, that follow what I'm doing, are going to be called the Jacksters. Now, the Discord and the Jacksters, that is something I've been planning on announcing for so long. My Discord was not ready for months. I actually just recently revisited it because I found a video that was super helpful to actually make it really, really good and professional. And it looks fantastic, in my opinion. There's a lot I think could be better, but I think it's really, really good, especially for a start. And I really want to share that with you guys. I want a place for where you guys can have quick links to my videos and streams. I want to have a place where we can share memes or we can just talk in general. I've been in some Discord servers where it's like, oh, the owner, don't at the owner because they're busy or whatever. It's like, don't at the mods either sometimes, which is like weird to me, in my opinion. It's like, if I'm going to make a Discord server so that the fans can kind of stay connected with me, why don't I let them talk to me as they want? And I will only restrict the rights if it, of course, becomes a problem, which I don't think it would be. But yes, so the Jacksters are the official name for the fan base, which is you guys. We have the Discord server, which will be going live at 50 subs, so get us up there. This is going to be cool, and I got a lot more cool stuff going on. The more subs that we have, the more people that stay engaged, the cooler the stuff's going to be. So we've got the Jacksters, the Discord, and the new hat and potential merch if you guys want it. Again, once we get to 50, I will release a form that anyone can access, as long as, of course, you have an email address, where you can sign up to pre-order these hats. You can either make up the same design, or if you'd like, we could do one a little differently. This could just be a prototype. We only made up one for now, just to make sure the design looked good, and it looks awesome, in my opinion. These are embroidered. They're not printed on. So they are stitched in, and this is a really good quality hat. These would charge probably around $30 to $35, something like that, and I know it's a little expensive for hats, but this is a really, really nice quality hat. And it's like the bill of it, I know you can't necessarily see it because of the black background and stuff, but it's like at least like an inch and a half thick. It's a pretty nice hat. I'm also considering doing shirts and or sweatshirts because the more of my own stuff I wear, the better the branding. Because the reality is, nobody pays me to wear these ACT shirts, and I'm just shouting them out now because of that. Nobody pays me for the Mossy Oak hat, and I just wear it because I like it, it's comfortable, and I have it. But I would be way more open to having my own hat. So it's some cool stuff. So quickly now, I'm going to jump right into the Royal Rumble review. The Royal Rumble was overall, you know what? I thought it was a pretty good show. I thought that there were a few things they could have done better for sure. Like, for example, Randy Orton leaving early in the Rumble. and then come back. That was dumb because it's like they did that with Roman Reigns in 2016. That was really obnoxious. Owens versus Reigns had the exact same throw off the stage onto the tables, and it was also pretty much a repeat of Edge and Randy Orton's WrestleMania match, the Last Man Standing match. It was more or less the same thing, to be completely honest with you. I didn't really dig it, and it was just repetitious, and I thought they could have done a lot better. They could have done a lot more with those matches, but for the most part, that was all of the bad. I like what they're doing with Ric Flair and Lacey Evans. I don't like that Nia and Shayna have the belts just because I don't like either of them. I think that Nia and Shayna are not that great in the ring, especially Nia. I mean, Nia constantly injuring people. She's not everybody else. And I'm not saying that, like, oh, she should fall in line with the crowd, be exactly like everyone else. But I think she's too different that it's not a good thing, which I think is a thing that can happen. And with Shayna, it's like, she wasn't that great in MMA, I don't think, from what I've seen of it. And I don't think she's that good in WWE. She went to, like, there were like 4 or 5 moves that she didn't do right at all, or she like slipped and dropped people. It's like, why are you doing that? It's like, all you know how to do is a rear choke, and it's annoying. But that, for the most part, was the only negatives that I can think of off the top of my head. Let's run through the matches, okay? I'm not in any particular order, because I don't remember exactly what order the card was in, but I have written down the majority of what there was. So, we'll start off with McIntyre versus Goldberg. McIntyre versus Goldberg was awful, because it was a finisher fest. And what I mean by that means it is a quick match where all that happens in the match are finishers. Do I like these? No. Even if they're both people I like? Right. So, I like Goldberg fine. He's, you know, whatever. He's okay. He's not great. He's definitely not good. I think a guy who comes in, does a spear and a jackhammer 2 or 3 times every single time he's there, that's not good. Like, makes, like, have some variety. It's almost always the same moves. Oh, hit, you know, jackhammer, spear. That's pretty much all his matches. And I think the only reason they did that match was because McIntyre had nothing to do going into WrestleMania, or going into the Rumble, but they want to keep building him for Mania. So I think that's why they did it like that. But I think it could have been done better, or just taken off entirely. Now, Sasha versus Carmella. I really liked this match. I think that Carmella, the new, like, kind of thing they're doing with her, where she's not the Princess of Staten Island and all that stuff. Like, I think that's way better now. I didn't hate it back when she was doing that, but I think it's a lot better now. And I think, especially with Reginald, man, Reginald was awesome. His match with Sasha was not needed, but man, that dude can move. He is fantastic. I really hope eventually they use him for singles competition, or at least tag team competition, so he's doing something more than being a sidekick. But I still enjoyed the match, that being said. Okay, so now let's talk about the Women's Royal Rumble. So, I thought this was a pretty good match. You know, I think it's pretty decent every year. One of the things I don't like that they do every single year is they have the same exact stars, for the most part, come back. It's like every year it's Molly Holly and Beth Phoenix and you know, it's always the same people. I have nothing wrong with that necessarily, but change it up a little. And this year they did. They had a few different people, and I thought that was really good. Thank God for that. I'm still waiting for the one where they have Santino come back as Santina in that Rumble. That's what I'm waiting for. So, I thought it was a pretty good match. Bianca Belair winning, that was fantastic. Like, it was already a pretty good match. That was just the icing on the cake. Up next, we have Reigns versus Owens, the last man standing match. I was disappointed. So one problem was, like I said, very similar to Edge versus Orton at Mania last year. Another problem with the match was that it went on for far too long. Another problem was they did repeats of things they've already done building up. And I understand, if you have a big spot 1 week, and you have that lead up to them doing that same big spot in the pay-per-view, like, oh, just like you did 3 weeks ago on Raw, that's different than using the same thing at the exact same angle, doing it the exact same way with no change, leading to ultimately less of an impact. Because on Raw, when Reigns threw Owens off of the stage, of the screens for the Thunderdome, into the tables, he didn't get up for several minutes. What happened at the Rumble? Threw him off the exact same way, pretty much the exact same spot, and he got up within a 10 count because of the stipulation of the match. This was not a good idea. I don't know why they did this. Other than that, though, it was alright. It wasn't terrible, it just wasn't great. It wasn't anything to write home about. Now let's talk about the Men's Royal Rumble. Where do I begin? So, Edge announces he's going to be in the Rumble again. After being out for almost half a year, I believe. So he ends up coming out at number one. Oh, that's interesting. I didn't think they were going to do that. But since he already declared it, he would have been arguably their biggest competitor in that match, given who was there. Would have made most sense to just have him start out first since he had already announced it. So I like the way they did that. We also saw Dominic Mysterio's Royal Rumble debut. This was... I thought this was really good, the way that they did it, because Dominic's really good. He's a great competitor. But I don't know if he would have been able to hang for very long in the Rumble. So what happened? So he ended up in the Rumble for like a minute. Maybe two, maybe three. This is why it was a good idea, okay? A Royal Rumble is great for a young guy or a new guy to go in and to kind of feel it out, get the feeling of being in the ring while having the spotlight not be on them for very long. You know, you come in, you do your high spot, then you get hit, so and then you stay in the corner, you stay down on the mat for a few minutes. That's a great way to start somebody out. I think he definitely could have done more, though. But regardless, that's why I think it was a good idea to have Dominic do what he did. I thought, I was like, when he got out, I was like, oh, man, I wish he would have been in there longer. But I'm like, yeah, but could benefit him. Now, we did see another return that, who also returned last year that I loved. This was Christian coming back again. So I'm going to say this now, considering this is post-show, right? But, being post-show, knowing what happened, I knew this last year, okay? Christian came back last year during the thing where Edge, the feud where Edge and Orton were going at it, and Orton was punt-kicking him, and RKO'd Beth Phoenix and stuff, and so Christian came out. So I could tell as soon as I saw Christian, whether he was actually going to like have a lengthy match that night, which he didn't, whether he did or not, I could tell by the way he looked. He was in good shape. He wasn't, like, looking flabby. He wasn't looking like he had been out of the ring for a while. He wasn't looking beaten down or older or broken, you know, because he's an older guy. He's not young. He's not old, but he's not young. So I could tell as soon as I saw his physique that night, I was like, yep, he's going to come back and wrestle. I don't know when, but he's not done with this company. Lo and behold, a year later, at the Royal Rumble, he came back again to wrestle this time. Actually wrestle, not just do a little one-off. And, oh my god, was it so awesome to see him back in the ring. And he did great. He looked great. You could tell he was feeling it. Him and Edge were both, like, having a great time together. It was awesome. And I'm not even, like, a giant Christian fan, because he was a little bit before my time. I started watching at the very end of his career. But I heard that, like, the week before or whatever, he got cleared, and so they were like, you know what, put him in the Rumble. And I'm really glad they did. And supposedly, he's not done. Supposedly, that was just one of many upcoming appearances for him, which is awesome. Because supposedly, before that, it was going to be a one-off. When I first heard about that, I was like, I really hope it's not a one-off, but it may be. But I was like, he's in such good shape, there's no way. He's got to be coming back. It's like, Edge has come back. Daniel Bryan has come back. I'm sure Paige will be back at some point. So I'm sure that he's going to be there for quite a while now. But yes, Edge came out on top because Seth Rollins took out two of the last two guys. It was Christian and then somebody else. Edge managed to stay in. Seth ended up getting taken out in that mix. And then Orton comes back in. RKO's Edge. Looks like he's about to throw Edge out. Edge reverses it, tosses him over the top rope to win the Royal Rumble. This was actually 11 years, I believe. 10 or 11 years to the day that since he had won his last Rumble, I believe is what they said during the broadcast. I also want to mention this. I just realized I completely forgot it. Carlito. Carlito was there. He made his return, and he was also on Raw on Monday. Wow. It was weird to see him, especially looking as good as he did. Like, he came back. He was, as far as I know, the most jacked he's ever been. He looked phenomenal. He had really cool facial hair now. His hair was bigger and everything. He just looked awesome. He came out with his Apple. It was great. I was so excited when I saw that. Because, unfortunately, I heard rumors that he was at the Performance Center, like, the day before. And he was supposed to be at the Rumble and on Raw. And I was like, oh, man, I wish I didn't see that article. But it was still cool to see him, you know? Just, it was one of those that wasn't as much of a surprise. But it was still cool. And it's funny, because I actually said to my dad, I was like, how much do you want to bet that he had to go either buy or have made a new set of gear? Because there is no way that after all this time, he still has gear laying around. And like, maybe, but I would doubt it. And he was like, yeah, no, he 100% had to get new gear. So, those were my thoughts on the 2021 Royal Rumble. Let me know what you guys think down in the comments. I would love to hear what you guys have to say about it. I'm interested about this. If you guys want more wrestling videos, let me know. I'm going to plan on doing more. I'm planning on getting some more wrestling gaming on. I just need to get the games on my PC because most of them are on my Xbox. And as far as I know, at least, there's no way for me to record my Xbox through my PC. Maybe there is, like hardwired. I know there's a way to stream it. I've tried it. It has awful network bandwidth. It's not good. It doesn't work well. So if I can figure out a way to do that, I would love to do some gaming. If not, I'll just have to buy them on my PC. Whatever, no huge deal. I can actually get a couple of them for free, depending on what the specific games are. There's some more indie wrestling games that I have seen, more indie-style wrestling games, not necessarily about indie promotions. But that is all I have for you guys this week. I hope you guys enjoyed. Yep, some new hats. Like I said, let me know. Let's get up to 50 subs. We'll get that. We'll get the Discord open. We'll get some hats going. Let's make some stuff happen. I have some new projects on the way, one in particular that I'm hoping to do very, very soon. I just need a definitive date from the person or people who are going to be collaborating with me on it, at least for the first part of it. And other than that, I will be streaming some more soon, hopefully. I'm done with streaming Fortnite because every single time, I know I say every single time and I've only done two streams, both times I've streamed Fortnite, I've gotten copyright claims. Thankfully, it's not where you get removed from the platform altogether or get your videos removed. But a copyright claim basically means you can't get it monetized, and sometimes, depending on what it is, it's blocked in certain countries, depending on, like I said, what the material is. They even got me copyrighted for the in-car audio in the game when you're driving around. I was like, yep. This was after I tried to just mute the audios in those sections of the streams multiple times, and I was like, no, this is dumb. I'm going to do what I can. I'm going to try as many times as I need to get the streams not copywritten, even if it means I have to cut out the section entirely. But as far as the rest of it goes, it's like, I'm just not going to stream Fortnite. So hopefully we'll be doing some Among Us soon, although it's tough with that game when you can't use voice chat. And it's always a gamble with randos, because you never know what they're going to say. But yes, other than that, that is all we have for you this week. Stay tuned for the hats, get them sub counts up, let's see what we can do, we'll get that Discord open. Let me know what you guys think in the comments. You want more wrestling, stuff like that. Let me guys know. That's a thing I said. Let me know what you guys want to see next going forward, because I will do everything I can to make the content that you guys want to see, assuming it's not a burden for me to make it. So with all that being said, thank you guys for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed. I'll see you guys next week.